हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल इलेक्ट्रिकल टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इंडस्ट्रियल प्रैक्टिस। सो टुडे आई विल मेक वीडियो ऑन पार्शियल बसबार डिफरेंशियल प्रोटेक्शन। यू कैन सी दैट द टॉपिक इज पार्शियल बसबार डिफरेंशियल प्रोटेक्शन एंड आई एम मेकिंग वीडियो आफ्टर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम इन माई ओल्ड फॉर्मैट, ओल्ड सेटअप। सो लेट्स बिगिन द वीडियो। Okay, so first we will see the basic single line diagram of for a partial busbar differential protection. Now, what is the difference between the a conventional busbar differential and partial busbar differential? You can see that in a conventional busbar differential, there are CTs in the outgoing, but in partial differential, there is no differential CT for the outgoing. So this is incomer 1, this is incomer 2, this is the bus coupler. So the both the incomers will have one CT each, and from the other bus section there will be another CT which will be connected to an overcurrent relay. For here, for this section also, this is another connection. Okay, so this is zone 1, this is a zone 1, and this is zone 2. Okay, so this is how the zones are divided. So and the output of the relay is fed to this zone 1 will trip the incomer 1 and bus coupler, and this zone 2 protection will trip the incomer 2 and bus coupler. Okay, and the other thing is outgoings do not have any CT as like the full busbar differential protection. Okay, so this is the basic single line diagram for a partial busbar differential. Now there are two catch points. Okay, number one catch point is that pickup of each relay will be higher than the full load current the incomer can carry at any condition. Okay, so if the incomer are running in parallel, or the one incomer is running taking the full load of the bus bar, then pickup of this relay shall be higher than that load current. Why, I will explain it later. And the CT connection shall be such that it will give some of current for fault inside the zone. That means if there is any fault here, then this relay, these two CT will see some of current. And if there is any fault outside the zone, then these two CT will give differential current. And these two CT will see the summation of current. So how, we will see it later. Okay. Okay. So here you can see that I have explained the scenario with one CT. I do not have considered the incomer to zone 2 side. So both the incomers are running, so it is a basically a parallel system. Okay, so this is CT, this is another CT, these two are differentially connected with a 51 relay. So now you can see that the CT connections, the polarities are marked here. So if the fault is outside the zone, outside of the protection zone, this is the zone. So if the fault is outside of the protection zone, then how the current will flow? The fault current will come here, and through this bus bar it will go to the fault point, right? So when the current is coming here, then the CT, through the current CT, the current will flow is in this direction, and as the current is going here, this CT will circulate the current at this direction. So when the fault current is outside the protection zone, this 51 is seeing a differential current. That is, this for this CT the current is in this direction, and for this CT the current is at this direction. Okay. So now we will see what will happen for the fault inside inside zone, protection zone. If the fault happens inside protection zone, we will see what will happen. So this case indicates the fault inside the protection zone. So when there is a fault inside the protection zone, the incomer will have a current like this. Current is flowing at this direction, and from incomer to the current is flowing under this direction. So here the current is flowing like this way downwards, and here also, here you can see that the current is flowing also downwards. Okay, so here the currents are submissive. So obviously for a in fault inside the protection zone, the relay will see higher current, and for fault outside the protection zone, the relay will see lower current. So obviously it will pick up for the fault inside the protection zone. Okay, so now let us see some cases when there is the bus coupler is open condition. Bus coupler or one incomer is open condition. What will be the cases we will see here? So So for operation, this is case 1 when the vascular is open condition. So you can see, now remember one thing, that the CT should be placed before the outgoing. So no outgoing shall be placed after the CT. So here at this position, there will not be any outgoing. All the outgoings will be outside of the CT zone, right? Okay, so here you can see that there are two incomers. Two incomers are working and the vascular is open condition, right? So fault has happened at this bus section. So as the vascular is open condition, so both the CT will see the current zero. This bus is healthy, so incomer 1 will see load current. I have already said we will make the pickup at 120% of the load current. Already I have said that we will set the pickup higher than the load current it can take. And here the fault has happened. So this CT is seeing zero, this CT is seeing the fault current. So fault current is obviously much more higher than the load current. So this relay will pick up. So this relay will pick up and it will send a trip signal to the bus coupler and to the incomer 2. Since the bus coupler is already open condition, the incomer 2 will be tripped and this faulty bus will be isolated, right? Now we will check the other condition, that is bus coupler closed and one incomer is opened. So here you can see that incomer 2 is open, bus coupler is closed. So the fault has happened at this point. So what will happen? You can see the entire fault current is getting fed through IF1, the entire fault current is getting fed through the incomer 1. So the fault current is traveling like this way. So current is going and traveling to this fault point, right? Now this CT is seeing same fault current. This is IF1. The same IF1 is going through this CT. And since the fault is outside the protection zone, so this CT will see the differential current, right? So both the CT will give, this is IF1 by this CT and this is IF1 by this CT. So this will be differential current, hence this 51 will not operate. Now here this incomer is seeing zero current because the incomer 2 is open. So this corresponding CT is seeing zero current. And the IF1 is flowing through this CT. So this CT alone will feed the current to the 51. So this 51 will pick up, this virtual differential protection will pick up and it will give trip signal to this bus coupler and incomer 2. So since the incomer 2 is already open, the bus coupler will be opened here and the faulty bus section will be isolated, right? Now let us check another condition. If the faulty fault section is at this bus section A, what will happen? So here also the fault current is coming through incomer 1 and flowing through this path, and there is no current after that. Okay, since this incomer 2 is open, so no current is coming through this point. So what will happen? Since the fault has already occurred here, so this CT will see zero current. If there is no motor load, if there is any motor load, then this CT will see slightly marginal current. So this is feeding IF and this CT is ideally feeding zero. So these two will be additively connected. So this 51 will pick up. And this 51 will not pick up because there is no current at this incomer 2 either or this bus coupler CT, right? So so this relay will not pick up and only this relay will pick up. So this will send trip signal to this incomer 1 and this bus coupler. So this two will trip and the faulty bus section will be isolated. So in this case, the entire switchboard will be switched off, and when if there is all the feeders are running parallel, so you can, I have shown it for incomer 1 close and bus coupler open and incomer 2 open condition. You can check similar way for incomer 1 open condition also. Now for all the feeders running parallel, what will happen? So for all the feeders running in parallel, this condition will be checked. That is, if the fault is happened outside of the busbar protection zone, zonal protection, then the current will be differential. And if it is happened inside the protection zone, the current will be summative. So based on that, the respective relay tripping selection will be done, right? And the corresponding tripping will be happened. So this is the basic operating principle of the partial busbar differential. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed, please like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel. And please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications of our video. Thank you very much for watching this video.